In this video, I'll do a review and walkthrough of Voicely, a product by VidTune. I'll take you inside the members area and do a quick demo so you can see how it works. I'll go over my pros and cons, and lastly, I'll give you my personal opinion on whether or not this voiceover product is worth picking up. So if you're ready, let's dive right in. Before we head into the meat of this review, I wanted to let you guys know that I was provided access to this product by the folks over at VidTune in exchange for a review. Now, I am not being compensated by VidTune, nor am I an affiliate of this product. I was told that Voicely was sold as an upsell to the VidTune product, and that Voicely upsell is available for $69. But as you'll see in this review, you can get it as a standalone product if you so choose, and I'll tell you where you can get that. So what are some of the main features of Voicely? Well, Voicely touts itself as the only web app multilingual voiceover generator with more than 400 voices and up to 60 languages. Now, just because you have more voices than the next guy doesn't mean it's good, by the way. They say they have no monthly fees. Technically, they are correct, but more on that in a minute. They incorporate different technologies such as Azure AI, IBM, Google, and Amazon. They say you can select the dialect and style from 300 plus voices available in the software, and that they are compatible with video editing software, which to me is not that big of a differentiator. All right, so we're inside of the VidTune dashboard. And as you can see, I only have access to the Voicely upsell. This Voicely upsell is being sold at a one-time price of $69, and it comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Again, it's $69 one time, 30-day money-back guarantee. Now, because I review a lot of products, I decided to do more research on Voicely, and much to my surprise, I found out that you can get Voicely at a one-time price of $49, and with the appsumo guarantee, you get it for 60 days. You get a 60-day money-back guarantee. So that was a big surprise to me. So if you guys are interested, after watching this review and learning more about it, if you guys are interested in picking up Voicely, then you can get it for $20 cheaper and get a 60-day money-back guarantee from appsumo. Now, I was a little disappointed when I found that out because I wish that VidTune had told me about that. But I really want to just go in and show you the product itself and evaluate that. And as we go through it, I'm gonna bring up areas of concern because you need to know about this stuff before you decide whether or not you wanna pick it up. So the Voicely dashboard is very clean, it's very simple. All you have to do is paste in your text here or type it in. So I'm gonna just paste in my text. And right here are the settings. So you're gonna choose from the different languages. You can see they've got a lot of languages available. I only know how to speak English, folks, so we're sticking with English US. And when you scroll down here, you're gonna see a bunch of different voices. So there's basic voices right here. So they've got two basic voices. They've got standard voices. And as you scroll down the standard voices, you're gonna see this word neural on here. And so I'm assuming that's gonna be a little bit more different. And then when you get to the natural voices, you also see neural there as well. But I'm assuming that these voices are gonna be better than the standard or basic voices. Then from there, you can choose your text to speech speed. You can also change the pitch. And this is where you're gonna generate your text to speech. And down here, this is where the output is gonna end up. You can adjust the volume. You can also add a soundtrack. So if you're in here, you can choose a soundtrack. And they've got a lot of different soundtrack options for you. One of the things I would like for them to do is to add a preview mode on this, so if you hover over it, that it would play a preview so you can hear what the soundtrack sounds like. Because while they have a lot of soundtracks to choose from, that means they have a lot of soundtracks for you to have to go through and figure out whether or not you want to use them. So that's one thing that I hope that VidTune would consider for future updates if they decide to update that. Or you can also upload your own soundtrack. Now, let's go ahead and let's just dive into some of the voices so you can hear what they sound like. So there are the basic voices. They have a female voice and a male voice. And one of the things that I notice is that when you select the male voice, these two options pop up here where you can add a break and you can say as. So the breaks are milliseconds and seconds. The say as, this part right here, they didn't really have training on it. So I really can't explain what this does other than in one of the videos they showed, they only have two training videos. One video is from the sales page. The other video is a demo of how to use it. They do talk about the telephone and they show how it reads the numbers better than other standard text-to-speech applications. But I really didn't see much of a difference and I didn't see anything else that goes in depth here. Because one of the things is when you buy this product, obviously they make it sound like it's easy and it really is because you just pop in the text and you generate it. However, if you want to tweak it, if you want to dive a little bit deeper and you want to perfect the voice, you need to know how to use this stuff. And nowhere on their training did they do that. So that was an area of concern for me because if I buy a product, I want to learn how to use it. I want to master it so that I can use it to its fullest potential. So let's go ahead and let's just start off with the Henry voice here and we'll generate the text-to-speech. I'm not going to add any breaks or I'm not going to choose any of these right here. That's something that you're going to have to go through as you learn how to use this product. So let's generate the text-to-speech. And you can see that it loads very quickly. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to play this so you can hear the sample.
Hey, it's Ken. For several frustrating years, I tried desperately to crack the code and start making money online. But I simply could not fit the pieces of the puzzle together. I always felt I was missing something. You know the feeling I'm talking about, right? If you could just...
So for a basic voice, yeah, it sounds okay. You can tell that it does sound mechanical. It doesn't sound natural. Doesn't have some of the inflections. Although I give it credit, when it got to this point right here where it asked the question, it did add that inflection to indicate that it was a question. So that was really good. However, the rest of it, it sounded fake. It sounded mechanical and it sounded like a computer generated voice. So that was the basic voice. So let's go ahead and take a look at the standard voices. So you can see they've got a bunch of different standard voices. They also have neural voices here. So let's go ahead and start off with the Liam standard voice and let's go ahead and generate the text-to-speech. And this popped up. So when I first started demoing this and learning how to use it, this box popped up. So what that means is that you work off of a credit-based system. When you purchase it, you get 50 credits. That's something to consider as well. But with those 50 credits, they said that it equates to roughly 10 hours of neural voices or 20 hours of standard voices. And then when you run out, you have to buy more. So after we generate this, I'm going to show you how much it costs to buy more credits. And I gotta say, when I saw how much it costs, I nearly fell out of my chair. So let's go ahead and let's generate this so you can hear what it sounds like. The Liam male voice, this is the standard voice.
Hey, it's Ken. For several frustrating years, I tried desperately to crack the code and start making money online. But I simply could not fit the pieces of the puzzle together. I always felt I was missing something. You know the feeling I'm talking about, right? If you could just find that something.
Okay, so that sounds a little bit better. I don't really see the difference between the standard voice and the basic voice. I know that the basic voice, you can use as many times as you want. They're not going to charge you anything. The standard voice, and as you see, as we get into the different or the higher level of voices, they're going to charge you more. So you have to be aware of that as well. Now, let's go ahead and I want to show you where you can buy these credits. So you go up here and you see this pops up and you can see it's very tiny, but you can see how many credits you have available. And if you want to buy credits, you go right here. And these are the packages that they offer you. 1,000 credits for $99, 2,000 credits for $196, 5,000 credits for $490. Now that was not mentioned to me. I had to actually dig for that and I found that in the frequently asked questions section. So that's how I found out about this. And when I went into the VidTune or the Voicely app itself and the credit system popped up, that's when I realized that you got to pay for credits. So let's continue on here. And so let's go down the line here because we were in the standard voices. And now I want us to do a standard neural voice. So let's go ahead and find a standard neural voice. Let's go with one right here, male voice. Let's go with Harold. This is the neural voice. Again, I'm not gonna add any breaks or customize it using the say as. And I'm gonna just generate the text-to-speech. So again, you can see that it uses credits. So you have to okay that in order for them to generate the voice file. Let's go ahead and play that.
Hey, it's Ken. For several frustrating years, I tried desperately to crack the code and start making money online. But I simply could not fit the pieces of the puzzle together. I always felt I was missing something. You know the feeling I'm talking about, right? If you could just find that.
So that sounds a little bit better. It still sounds a little mechanical to me and a little computer generated. However, it did catch the inflection of this question right here, which is nice because some other voiceover technologies, some of the other text-to-speech technologies or apps out there can't handle that. So it's nice to see that this text-to-speech software can do that. Now let's go ahead and let's explore the natural voices. So let's go ahead and pick a natural voice. So we've got natural voices down here. We've got guy. Let's start up right here. Let's start up with the guy neural under natural voices. See how that sounds. Let's generate that. And it uses more, to me, it uses more credits. The better the voice, the more credits you use. So let's generate that voice and see what it sounds like.
Hey, it's Ken. For several frustrating years, I tried desperately to crack the code and start making money online. But I simply could not fit the pieces of the puzzle together. I always felt I was missing something. You know the feeling I'm talking about, right?
So that sounds a little bit better. It seems like it had more natural. Again, this is under the natural voices area. It seemed like it had more of a natural, comfortable tone to it. And so it sounds a little bit better. So let's go ahead and scroll down it because I see these version 3s right here. So I'm kind of anxious to see what these sound like. So let's go with Kevin, male, version 3. So it sounds like they've updated it at least, which is nice to see. Let's generate that text to speech. And you can see it takes up more credits. And we're going to run out of credits. Hopefully we won't run out before this review is over. And then we'll see what this voice sounds like. So that took a little bit longer, so I'm encouraged that maybe this voice will sound the best. So let's go ahead and play that.
Hey, it's Ken. For several frustrating years, I tried desperately to crack the code and start making money online. But I simply could not fit the pieces of the puzzle together. I always felt I was missing something. You know the feeling I'm talking about, right? If you could just find that.
So the voice sounds more stereo, I guess, to me. It sounds like they've polished it. It sounds more natural too. However, it didn't catch this inflection where this is how I would read it. You know the feeling I'm talking about, right? Whereas some of the other options did. So I don't understand how you would pay more for a voice that sounds better, but yet can't deliver these kinds of inflections, which the others did. So that part kind of confuses me. So those are the voices that, and the demo of how to use Voicely. So I also wanted to go over those concerns with you so that you were aware of what you're getting into. So it does cost credits. And so you need to understand that it's going to take some time and that if you do experiment with this and you try to learn how to use it, you're gonna have to end up buying more credits sooner or later. Let's go over my pros and cons. First, the pros. On a basic level, it does what it's supposed to do, and that is produce a voiceover. It incorporates different technologies, which gives you a variety of voices with pitch, tone, and a bunch of other features. And that means you have lots of voices to choose from. But like I said, More is not necessarily better. Plus, you get a 30-day money-back guarantee if you buy it as part of the upsell to VidTune, or you get a 60-day money-back guarantee if you buy it via AppSumo. Now the cons. There are just too many voices to choose from. Let me ask you this. How many voices do you really need? I wish these software makers would create just a few voices and invest the rest of their time and money making them really good. What's the use of having a ton of voices when at the end of the day, just one or two are worth using? It works off a credit system, so it's a one-time price, but you only get 50 credits. This equates to roughly 10 hours of neural or 20 hours of standard voiceovers. When you run out, you have to buy more. And the credit packages aren't cheap, folks. I wish they were more upfront about this and not bury it in the frequently asked questions section. So the more you test, the more credits you use. It would be great if they had a preview mode to allow you to hear the voiceover and then charge you credits when you want the higher quality version. It would also be nice to see a permanent graphic on the dashboard that shows how many credits you have left. It takes time to master. And like anything, you need to spend the time and the credits to learn how to edit the voices to make it sound as real as possible. So it can be an expensive process overall. And unfortunately, there are only a handful of you folks out there who are willing to put in the time to learn how to master it. The ones who don't will always complain that the software doesn't work. If English is not your first language and your grammar is poor, no text-to-speech software is going to help you. The voice can sound as real as possible, but if your grammar is not up to par, it won't matter. So is Voicely worth picking up? Well, that answer depends largely upon you. For me, I wouldn't recommend picking this up unless you really like these voices. Then if you do, you need to realize that you'll have to learn how to use it, and that takes time and credits. Are you willing to purchase one of those packages I mentioned earlier, starting at $99 and going all the way up to $490? Sure, you can use the basic voices, but they don't sound good at all. So what do you think? Are you going to pick up Voicely? Let me know by dropping your comment down below. Thanks for watching my Voicely review. If you found this review to be helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more content like this. This is Ken Furukawa from kenfurukawa.com, and I'll see you in my next video.